Hello everyone, today is day 1 of code drift and we are going to begin with solving the problem Sasri doesn't like to wait.
In this problem, Sasri and his partner Deidre want to attack Gaara. In order to attack Gaara, Deidre sends N detonating birds towards Gaara at the same time. The ith bird takes AI time to detonate. Only one bird can detonate at a time, and when the next turn of the next bird comes in, it will also take its time as given in the array A. The waiting time of the bird will be the sum of time taken by all the birds before it. Total wait time is the sum of the waiting time of the each bird. Everyone knows that Sasri doesn't like to wait. Deidre wants to make this process as quick as possible. You can arrange the attacking bird in any order. Find the minimum total waiting time. Constraint on N, which is the total number of bird in this problem, is from 10 to is up to 10 to the power 5. And constraint on AI, which is the detonating time of individual bird, is up to 10 to the power 5. So let's take an example of N is equals to 5 and A is equals to 3, 2, 1, 10, 5. So this denotes that there are 5 birds and detonating time of the first bird is 3. So let's calculate the waiting time of each element. So we are given that the waiting time of each bird is sum of all the birds that came before it. So the waiting time of the first element will be equals to 0. For the second element, it will be 3. For the third element, it will be 3 plus 2, 5. For the third element, it will be 5 plus 1, 6. And for the last element, it will be 6 plus 10 is equals to 16. And our final answer will be equals to the waiting time of the sum of waiting time of all the birds. So it will be 0 plus 3 plus 5 plus 6 plus 16. And in the end, it will be equals to 30. So this will be our final answer for this example, and we know this is the method to calculate it. So let's take one example that if we swap these two elements, 10 and 5, what will happen? So A will be equals to 3, 2, 1, 5, 10. And the waiting time of the first bird will be equals to 0. For the second element, it will be 3. For the third, it will be 3 plus 2, 5. For the fourth element, it will be 3 plus 2 plus 1 is equals to 6, and for the final element, it will be 6 plus 5 is equals to 11, and the sum of waiting time of all the elements will be 0 plus 3 plus 5 plus 6 plus 11, and it will be equals to 25. So by swapping two elements, we have improved our answer from 30 to 25. So let's take a general case of two elements A and B. So if we put them in this order, A comma B, the waiting time of the first bird will be equals to 0. For the second bird, it will be equals to A. And if we put them in this order, B comma A, the waiting time of the first bird will be equals to 0. And for the second bird, it will be equals to B. So our final answer here will be equals to 0 plus A is equals to A. And in this case, it will be 0 plus B is equals to B. So it is in the end, if we put in this order A comma B, the final answer will be A, and if we put them in the order B comma A, the final answer will be equals to B. So in all the cases where A is less than B, it is always optimal to put them in the order A comma B, and when B is less than A, it is always optimal to put them in the order B comma A. So it is always optimal to put them in the sorted order. So from this we can get that it is always optimal to put array A in the sorted order. So in this example, let's take, if we sort this array, what will happen? So A will be equals to 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, and the waiting time will be 0, 1, 3, 6, 11 respectively. The waiting time of each element is the sum of all the elements that came before it, and the sum of waiting time of all the birds will be equals to 0 plus 1 plus 3 plus 6 plus 11, and it will be equals to 21, which is better than our previous answer 25. So after sorting this array, we have improved our answer, and here we have shown that the sorting of array A is always optimal, and now we will understand its code. So in the solution code, we are getting array A as one of our argument, and we are creating two variable answer and sum. Answer to store our final answer and sum to store the prefix sums. So the value of the answer can be at maximum answer is equals to, if all the variables are 10 to the power 5, in that case our final answer can be at maximum is equals to 10 to the power 5 into 10 to the power 5 into 10 to the power 5. which won't fit into the integer variable, so we are creating long long variable. And sum can be at maximum is equals to 10 to the power 5 into 10 to the power 5. And long long variable can store these large values. After that we are sorting the array A. Here we are sorting the array A in ascending order. And then we are iterating over all the elements. So this is for each iterator. It will iterate over all the values of A and I will store each individual value of A. After that we are adding sum to our answer and then we are adding I to our prefix sums. So let's create a table to understand this iteration here. Let's take this example of A is equals to 1, 2, 3, 5, 10. So this will be array A after sorting. So after the first iteration, we will add the value of the sum to answer. So the value of the sum was 0, so answer will be 0. After that, we will add the element I to sum. So 1 will be added to the sum. So after this iteration, sum will store the value of 1. In the second iteration, we will add the value of the sum to our answer. So answer becomes 1. And we will add I, which is equal to 2, to the sum, so it will be is equals to 3. After the third iteration, sum will, answer will be 1 plus 3 is equals to 4, and the sum will be is equals to 3 plus 3 is equals to 6. And in the fourth iteration, we will add the value of 6 to our answer. It will be answer is equals to 10, and sum will be is equals to 6 plus 5 is equals to 11. In the last iteration, value of the answer will be is equals to 21, and value of the sum will be is equals to 20. One as well. So this value of the answer will be our final answer, and it will be, we will take its modulo with respect to 10 to the power 9 plus 7. Here we are taking its modulus and then we are returning our answer. So here we are returning our answer. So now let's analyze its time complexity and space complexity. So the time complexity of our solution will be O of n log n, where n is the size of array A. So this time complexity comes from the sorting of array A. So in this step here, we are sorting the array A, and sorting takes O of n log n time, where n is the size of the array to be sorted. Hence the time complexity will be O of n log n, and space complexity will be O of 1, because we are not using any extra space and just creating two variable answer and sum. So the space complexity will be constant.
Now we will solve the next question, k partition array. Now we are going to solve problem named k partition array.
In this problem, Aman has n chocolates as a sequence called A, where AI denotes the tastiness of chocolate I. He need to partition this array, and for any partition from L to R, the tastiness is defined as A of L plus A of R. Find the maximum tastiness which can be achieved by doing exactly k partition of this array. And total taste is defined as the sum of taste of each partition. Constraint on this problem are, the length of A is from 1 to 10 to the power 5, and K, the number of partition, is from 2 to 10 to the power 5, and AI, which is the taste of each chocolate, is from 1 to 10 to the power 5. So let's take an example. Let's n be equal to 7 and A be equal to 1, 2, 5, 4, 8, 1, 3, and k be equal to 4. So what does this mean is that there are 7 chocolates. The tastiness of first chocolate is 1, and we want to make exactly 4 partitions of these 7 elements. So let's denote each partition by a blue line. For example, let's take that first partition is from the first element to the second element. The second partition is from the third element to the fourth element, and the third partition is from fifth element to the sixth element, and fourth partition take only the last element. So the tastiness in this case will be tastiness of this segment plus the tastiness of this segment plus the tastiness of this segment plus the tastiness of this segment. So tastiness of the first segment will be equal to 1 plus 2. For the second segment, it will be 5 plus 4. For the third segment, it will be 8 plus 1. And for the last segment, it will be 3 plus 3. So it will be 3 plus 9 plus 9 plus 6. And it will be equals to 27. And we want to maximize this number. So here we understood that what is the method to calculate final tastiness of any arrangement. And this is the answer we got. And now, finally, we want to maximize this number, the total sum of tastiness of each segment. So it doesn't matter how we partition the array, the first element and the last element is always calculated. So this first element and the last element is always added in our answer. And for k partition, there will be k minus 1 blue lines which will divide those partition. And all the elements which are across those blue line are added ones. So in this case, the blue lines were between 2 and 3, 4 and 8, and 1 and 3. And all the elements that were across those blue lines were added in our answer. So this 2 and this 5, this 4 and this 8, this 1 and this 3 were added in our answer. So our final answer was the first element plus the last element plus these two elements which were across this first blue line, 2 plus 5, and the element which were across the second blue line, 4 and 8, and element which was which were across the third blue line, which was 1 and 3, and final answer was equal to 27. So here we can make an observation that for k partition there are k minus 1 blue line, and each element which is across the blue line is added once, and the first element and the last element is always added to our answer. So we know that only the first element and the last element and element across the blue lines matter. So the first element and the last element are always added. If we pick this k minus 1 blue lines optimally, we can maximize our answer. So to do so, we will create another temporary array B. So each element of B will store the sum of two adjacent elements. So B will be equals to 1 plus 2 comma 2 plus 5 comma 5 plus 4 comma 4 plus 8 comma 8 plus 1 comma 1 plus 3. So B will be equals to 3 comma 7 comma 9 comma 12 comma 9 comma 4. And there are k minus 1 blue lines. So we will pick k minus 1 max element from B. In this case, we will take 9, 12 and 9. So the partition will be equal to A is equals to 1 comma 2 comma 5 comma 4 comma 8 comma 1 comma 3. So the first 9 was sum of 5 and 4. So the first partition will be between 5 and 4. Second 12 was the sum of 8 and 4. So the second partition will be between 8 and 4. And the third 9 was the sum of 8 and 1. So the third partition will be here. In this case, our final answer will be 1 plus 5 plus 4 plus 4 plus 8 plus 8 plus 1 plus 3. And this will be equals to 34, which is better than 27. So we have improved our answer if we take greedily the location of k minus 1 blue line. So let's go through the solution code once. Here we are getting a vector a and integer variable b as our argument. Then we are creating a long variable max to store our final result. We are storing the variable b in k and size of array a in n. Then we are initializing our answer to the sum of first element and the last element, as we know that the first element and the last element are always included in our answer. Then we are creating a priority queue q1. Then in this segment of the code, we are taking the sum of two adjacent element. After taking the sum of two adjacent element, in this segment of the code, we are taking the maximum element in each iteration, and we are doing k minus 1 iteration. So we are taking k minus 1 maximum element from q1. So for this example of a equal to 1 comma 2 comma 5 comma 4 comma 8 comma 1 comma 3 and k equal to 4, q1 will be initially equal to 3 comma 7 comma 9 comma 12 comma 9 comma 4, and max will be is equals to the sum of first element and last element is equals to 4. So we will, for the value of k is equal to 4, so we will take k minus 1 maximum element from q1. So in the first iteration, we will take this at 12 and add this 12 to our max, and in the second iteration we will take 9, then we will add this 9 to max, then we will take the third maximum element, which is this 9, and then we will add this to max, and our final value of the max will be equals to 34, and this is our final result, and we will now return it. And in this statement here we are returning our final result of max. And now let's analyze the time complexity and space complexity of our solution. So the time complexity of this solution is k log n, where n is the size of array A and k is the number of partition to make. So this time complexity comes from this for loop. Here we are doing k iteration, and in each iteration we are popping the maximum element from priority queue q1. So removing the maximum element from a priority queue takes log time. So the overall time complexity of this solution will be k times log of n. And the space complexity of this solution is O of n. So this space complexity comes from the priority queue. So storing a priority queue of n elements take
O of n space.
The space complexity of this solution will be O of n. Thank you. Please like and subscribe.